I'm Marek Siarkowicz, one of the etcd maintainers. Unfortunately, Benjamin is not able to attend because of COVID restrictions, but he prepared a video that I will play during the presentation. But today, I wanted to talk to you about the etcd inconsistency issues. So earlier this year, there was an event that shocked the cloud-native ecosystem at all. The latest etcd release had a critical issue that etcd, the component that powers cloud-native solutions, including Kubernetes, it could corrupt your data. Every single administrator needed to take an action or risk their system becoming unrecoverable or requiring even direct byte fixes. With the popularity of Kubernetes, this means that millions of clusters needed to mitigate the issue. I think this is a serious problem. I hope you agree with me. And I think the community needs to make a conscious and direct actions to prevent such issues in the future, because we cannot build a cloud-native ecosystem on flaky and unreliable foundations. So today's session will take a form of postmortem review. Doing a postmortem review in a blameless or a blameless analysis is at the foundation of and core of the SRE culture. And I believe that also as an open source community, we should use or follow the same approach to make sure we as a whole learn from events like this and when can improve for a better future. So today, today's agenda, I will go through the etcd, introduce you to etcd, to at least for you to understand what happened. I will go shortly about data inconsistency, how it can occur, how etcd protects against that. Then I will play, Benjamin will tell you about how it really happened in case of etcd. And at the end, I will give you some lessons learned or what actions we will as a etcd to fix those. And yeah, and maybe some other personal learnings. So you may know that etcd is a distributed key value store that powers Kubernetes, but also other solutions. What distributed here means that there are multiple instances that work together as a single unit, a cluster. So no matter which instance you talk to or read from or write, you should get the same result. Writes, so if you write to any instance, should be visible on all of them. this etcd itself has built-in redundancy and resilience to failure, but this is not this is a hard problem. So to provide those strong guarantees, etcd uses called algorithm called Raft. Raft itself is so-called consensus algorithm that allows multiple servers or instances or members to agree on a single or on values. Consensus is a fundamental is fundamental in distributed systems like etcd. So etcd has it as part, it's a part of the core of etcd code. So every single decision that etcd makes is negotiated by Raft. What Raft does for etcd is takes an unordered set of events that happen that can go to any etcd instance, reorders them, and ensures that they are available or on each of the instances in the same order. So the ordered events, the Raft outputs, is called Raft log. So if we look how it works in etcd, let's say looking at three layers of API, the Raft implementation and the storage, if there's multiple requests trying to set the same key to different values, it's the question, which should be resolved first? And this is handled by Raft. So etcd starts this by creating an entry or message, or you could say in Raft proposal, of setting the value from each of the clients, or each server does it for each client, and then passes it to Raft. Raft takes those entries and put them in one long, you could say, queue, giving it an global order. And then each of those events are propagated to each server. And thanks to given, like, thanks that based on the stable order of the events, if every server applies them in the same order, they will end up with the the same result. So in our case, each server will first set X to 3, then to 1, and at the end, when the entry for setting 2 will be appended, it will set it to 2. So now, if let's look like how changes to the storage are applied. So to make persisting etcd state fast, it needs to be done in multiple stages. Raft lock is stored in memory, so when a new entry is added to it, we can immediately persist it to disk in so-called write-ahead log or wall. This is really fast because etcd operations are just appending a new entry and doing a consecutive writes to the disk. A part of the wall, etcd also stores the database file. The database file contains an aggregated state, so all the events that are squished into two values. So basically, they preserve one state or last state of all keys. And also, it has consistent index. Consistent index is basically a pointer between the storage and the wall. So let's look at what happened when etcd starts processing the second Raft entry. So if we want to, first the entry is applied to in-memory version of the database. It sets the new key value to 2, and at this point, etcd can already return results to the user because we persisted the state to the wall, and we also have applied the change to the in-memory state, so we know that the results from the write. This allows us to make the flash to the database asynchronous. So etcd does it every 5 seconds. Every 5 seconds, the state in memory is flashed to the disk. And with that, when the change is flashed, it will update the value of the key and also change the consistent index to point to the new value exactly the entry that was applied. So what then is the data inconsistency? If consensus is about multiple instances agreeing on the value, the data inconsistency is when this consensus, when it breaks. So no matter how cool is your three-head dragon, if one head is has its mind of its own and starts returning different results, this whole system is flawed. So if etcd Raft, or if etcd uses Raft and Raft is correct, what can happen to cause the data inconsistency? Like you can see, there are a lot of causes. So of course, hardware failures. The disk write can fail or not be fully persisted. It can happen, like you should always account for that. Of course, there can be bugs in in Raft, there could be problems with Raft lock being not consistently applied. So a bug in apply method. And the data, so the third case would, for bugs would be if the database is desynchronized from the Raft lock. So if anything touches the consistent index and passes their incorrect values, etcd could apply multiple some entries multiple times or totally skipped some of them. And the third one, the reason why it's so hard to support upgrades and downgrades in etcd is incompatibility of versions. So based on the how etcd works, there can be no changes that makes no any change can make difference in how the state of etcd ends up. So if there is any backward incompatible request or during downgrade, the etcd, the older version of etcd cannot interpret the entry differently because it will end up in different state. This is one of the reasons why etcd doesn't support multiple or versions queue larger than one, because we as a maintainers, we don't guarantee or don't check more than one version forward if there is any incompatibility. So of course, etcd has some methods to protect against this. This is the there are two methods up to version 3.5.4. And there was only the newest version has a new method introduced. So it's during when, so both methods are not enabled by default, but if you enable them, etcd will check the database hash when it joins clusters. So basically it prevents you to invalid member to from joining the cluster. And second one is periodic check. So etcd will go to other members, ask them, hey, what's the latest, or what's the, what values of you have for any specific revision? And they will respond, and if there's anything wrong or they got bad answer, etcd will raise the alarm and require administrator, or it will notify administrator that they should look it up. So knowing that, let's look at how the data inconsistency looked in etcd. This will be, here I have video from Benjamin. Okay. Check the sound.
VMware. I cannot go to KubeCon on site due to China's COVID.
Okay.
Hello, I'm Benjamin Wang, coming from VMware. I cannot go to KubeCon on site due to China's COVID-19 policy, so I have to deliver the presentation by video. Sorry for that. I will have a deep dive into the data inconsistent issue in this video, but I won't go into too many annoying details. Instead, I will present the key points using a couple of diagrams so as to be more clear and more direct. The issue number is 13766. I also provided a simple summary on this issue. Please feel free to read it offline. The issue isn't easy to reproduce. When etcd cluster is under high load and one member crashes, then the member's data might be inconsistent with other members after it restarts again. It might be a little difficult to understand now, but no worry, I will show you the root cause in the next few slides. First of all, we need to understand the transaction mode used in etcd. I believe everyone knows the concept of database transaction. It guarantees admissibility In etcd, there are two kinds of transactions, the etcd backend transaction and BoltDB transaction. You know, etcd uses BoltDB as the storage engine. When a BoltDB transaction is committed, then the data is guaranteed to be persisted on disk. But committing transaction is an expensive operation because it needs to sync data to disk. In order to have better performance, etcd commits the BoltDB transaction periodically instead of on each request. The default interval is 100 milliseconds. Etcd transaction is just a logical concept on top of BoltDB transaction. A BoltDB transaction might span multiple etcd transactions. When an etcd transaction is committed, it doesn't mean the data is successfully persisted on disk. But from users or client perspective, the etcd transaction also guarantees the full property, the ACID. You may challenge, what if an etcd instance crashes after it commits, but before the BoltDB transaction commits? The answer is the data will not be lost, because the data is already persisted in raw files. An etcd will replay the uncommitted entries from raw file on startup. The BoltDB transaction and etcd transactions are independent, which means they are created and committed in separate coroutines. The only limitation is that they are mutually exclusive. A BoltDB transaction can't be committed in need of any etcd transaction. Okay, this is the relationship between etcd transaction and BoltDB transaction. It's the base to understand the data inconsistent issue. The direct reason for the data inconsistent issue is the value of consistency index isn't correct. It doesn't match the applied data. The consistency index is actually the latest applied log index. Previously in etcd 2.4, etcd saves the consistency index into BoltDB at the end of each etcd transaction. There's no any issue in this diagram. But an improvement was added in etcd 2.5.0. A pre-committed hook was added, which is called each time before committing an BoltDB transaction. Etcd doesn't save the consistency index at the end of each etcd transaction anymore. Instead, it saves the value in the pre-commit hook. You know, a member may process hundreds of etcd transactions during each BoltDB transaction. So this solution reduced the hundreds of operations into only one. On the surface, it improved the efficiency or performance. But the enhanced solution caused the data inconsistent issue. You know, each pair of updating consistent index and the following etcd transaction belong to the same applied workflow. It is supposed to be atomic, but obviously it isn't. Let's work with an example. Assuming the BoltDB transaction is committed immediately after etcd updated the consistent index, and then the consistent index is successfully persisted on disk by the pre-commit hook. But etcd crashed for whatever reason before the corresponding etcd transaction starts. Then the etcd member runs into the data inconsistent issue because the consistent index is saved, but the related data isn't persisted. So in short, the atomicity of the applied workflow is broken, and it's exactly the root cause of the data inconsistent issue. Finally, we made two changes to resolve this issue. Firstly, we just save the consistent index into a staging variable before each etcd transaction. Secondly, we added a pre-lock, post-lock hook on the etcd transaction, and the hook is called each time right after an etcd transaction starts, and the consistent index is updated in the post-lock hook. No matter when the BoltDB transaction is committed, it guarantees that the consistent index is always consistent with the applied data. But the solution is too complicated and hard to maintain, so we added automatic verification to make sure any following changes by any new computer do not break anything. Let's put all the three diagrams in one slide to compare them again. The enhanced solution isn't correct because it breaks the atomicity of an applied workflow. Actually, the enhancement isn't necessary because I don't think it improves the performance. You know, any operation during a bolt transaction is actually updating the data in memory, so the overhead should be negligible. During each bolt transaction, it needs to load the related page into memory on demand in the very first time. It might have some overhead, but it should also be negligible because LCD may process hundreds of logical transactions in one bolt transaction, and only the very first operation in the first logic LCD transaction needs to load the page. So the ratio is very low. Another point is that there are also some other fields which are saved in the same bucket as the consistent index. Even without consistent index, LCD also needs to load the related page. So the consistent index doesn't add any extra overhead. So in summary, the enhancement isn't necessary. The final solution is also too complicated and hard to maintain. I'm planning to remove all the hook, including the post-lock hook and pre-commit hook. Eventually, the solution might be very similar to the original solution. Of course, I need to evaluate the performance impact by then. Yeah, that's all from my side. If you have any concern or question, please feel free to reach out to me by Slack or by email. Thank you. Bye.
Okay. let's now look into the lessons learned. So maybe it was not clear, but what led to the inconsistency was a simple refactor just to make the data inconsistency code clearer, but it resulted in basically one edge case or that could cause a race. So simple change that resulted in big consequences. If we will look at what went wrong when we were trying to fix the issue. This issue was not cut by the release qualification. We found out that with maintainer's turn, the new maintainer that took over release was not aware of all the release qualification that should be made, and it vastly lowered the quality or time we spent of qualifying it. Etcd didn't have a test suite that could even cut this class of issues. We were working on it, but this work was unfortunately deprioritized, and the person that was working on it left the project. there were already existing data inconsistency detection mechanism that was available for users to use, so we could find the issue earlier and start and make the fix and push the fix much faster instead of overall timeline taking us over a year. But unfortunately, there was no user adoption. The reason was the feature was not graduated and was still marked as experimental. The code fix took us 2 weeks, and I hope it was not because us, but the code was complicated enough that we needed multiple attempts to clean up and catch all the edge cases. Now I would like to go through how we are trying to address it. I will try to categorize the action items in a couple of ways. So first, we need to make sure to build in some mechanism to prevent this issue so it never went to anyone production. We should have some actions to if it goes into production or it's there, users should be able to detect the issue fast and in a reliable way. And in the end, when the issue is detected, there should be a way to mitigate the problem. And of course, as we cannot do anything, everything at all, or everything at once, and we have limited resources, we need to prioritize. The critical part we would want to address is etcd testing. We need to be able to prevent regressions and have a system of testing that can handle this class of issues and can reproduce them reliably, not randomly. We also need to have a detection mechanism enabled by default. And for that, we need to put much more work into stabilizing and making the mechanism, good quality of the mechanism good enough that every cluster can run it. For important issues, we need to improve the quality of testing. They should be, instead of flaky, they should be high quality, easy to maintain, and we should also be able to quickly expand them to cover new edge cases that we discover. Problem with fixing the issue, we should make the apply code easier to understand and validate correctness, because it was really hard for us to validate if what we are doing is correct. The critical etcd issues should never be abandoned. We should have a tracking mechanism and prioritize them accordingly. And etcd should be continuously qualified. On detection mechanism, we need to have the data detection of the data inconsistency should be reliable and and also validate the snapshots sent between leader and leader and followers. Mitigation. Before this event, we didn't even have documentation about how to recover from data inconsistency. Now we have documentation. We need to make sure that it works, and we should test that. Long term, we would want etcd to be able to automatically recover from these cases. We have ideas, we just need people to help make them true. We are having so many ideas or so great plans. What is the status of the work? There is a new data inconsistency check introduced that can be enabled now. It's much more reliable by handling slow followers, and it's much cheaper, making it easy enough to run every minute instead of hours. And we are running linear visibility test, which is a general system property that it behaves as it should. And we can easily reproduce all the issues that we encountered this year. Maybe my personal learnings. One thing with the churn of maintainers, I think that the contributor documentation is as important as the user one. We lost much of the knowledge that we had was lost just because maintainers moved to a new job, they changed their project, they cannot be reached by any means other, I think, or by emails. We need to stop to depend on one person knowing all the stuff. We need documentation and consistent execution of processes. And maybe second learning, the prioritization. There are many contributors that want to give us great new changes, make the etcd faster. We should be able to say no. It's really helped the project to make it 1% faster. It's much more, it's much better if everyone can trust that project is reliable, as it's even stated on the page. There's performance is not a priority for etcd. Then we should focus on reliability work and make sure that we are not trying to maintain too many performance improvements. And that's all I have prepared for today. Thank you for listening. And if you have any questions, there is a mic.
Can you summarize all the issues you have seen which caused the inconsistency across different zones of the data? I'm just wondering if you can summarize the list of reasons, technical detail level that contribute to the inconsistency in data.
In etcd case, so the question was, what is the main reason for inconsistency that we've seen? What I've seen, the problem is still, we are gradually fixing it one by one, but most of the problems we have with apply code, which is the code that technically takes what Raft gives as like history of what should happen, and then each etcd needs to apply it. So making sure that consistency index is updated at the same time, making sure that that the code catches correctly errors and handles authorization, which is different type of error, is the main source of issues that we've seen. And we've seen multiple tries and edge cases that that needed to be solved independently, because as we were fixing one, we were finding another issue in some other part of the big, huge switch statement to handle all the cases.
Have you seen anything which contributed by the RAT
itself? The more recent issue with durability was caused by, not by Raft itself, back in Raft, but lack of documentation in Raft that explained how to use Raft, and at some point someone misused Raft in some way. So we haven't seen a bug in Raft. It's hard to reproduce. We are just building tools that we could find issues in Raft. It's more about implementation of etcd, and there was a bug of implementation because Raft didn't document, like there was no documentation about one edge case.
Hi, this is one of the best post-mortem I have ever heard. So that's a compliment. I have a question for you. It's not directly related, but I hope maybe you have a chance to cover it later. We noticed the ETCT is very sensitive to latency, meaning that if for some reason that there is a latency occurred, then ETCD will have trouble response in time. Application will notice the issue. Is it a known issue?
There were a couple of bugs related to for example, latency causing leader elections or members needed, or some members being disconnected and going back to the cluster and causing more latency or forcing leader election. To my knowledge, most of them, they're fixed, but only on the latest versions.
Oh, thank you.
Hello. I think you mentioned is some of the potential forward-looking solutions is adding tests that would be able to exercise the code to determine whether or not it successfully does this algorithm. Has anyone attempted to write those tests? It seems like a very difficult thing to test given the complexity. It's not just like a simple unit test. So I'm curious, A, has anyone attempted to write it, or B, are there any existing tests that are very similar in terms of determining whether the algorithm results in consistency for many different cases?
Yes, the answer is yes. You should, if you're interested in that, there is Project Jepsen, which is maintained by one person that does a lot of contract work for databases. We etcd was from time to time major releases were verified with Jepsen. It's the main two issues for etcd is we don't have maintainers that know closure, and I don't think we will get to work on it. Maybe also so we would need to build a lot of things by ourselves. And yes, second, it was not built to be run as part of integration. So it's something that you can come in and run and maybe you'll find an issue. We want something that we can run consistently as part of our CI and automated so people don't need to think about like issue, or not need to think about, oh, where is the tool that protects, or how to qualify. The etcd should be qualified out of the box.
Any other questions? Okay, thank you. Wonderful seminar.